everyone. This week, we are focusing on Jesus's well-familiar parable of the prodigal son. And today, we are going to look at the younger brother as we talk about what it means to confess our sin. Well, you know the story well. A father has two sons, and the younger son decides that he's finished following dad's rules, living under his home where he's loved and provided for, because he wants to go out on his own, to have that freedom that comes from being an adult and making his own choices. So he goes to his dad and he demands his share of his father's inheritance. Well, I'm sure there were a few arguments back and forth, but the father relents and gives the younger son what he's asked for. So the boy takes it, decides he's gonna pack up everything he has and heads out for a life of partying, of prostitutes, of friends that only care about him because of what he can give them, of what he's providing. But after a time of living in sin, of living a life that is completely opposite from what he grew up with, from how he was raised, he finds that the land is without food and he's lost it all. He's lost all of his inheritance that was given to him by his father. His future is in shambles. And so now he's looking down at pigs. The only job that he could get was caring for these pigs, and he's starving. And he's staring down and just wishing that he could just have a little bit of the slop that they're eating. And let me tell you, when pig slop looks appetizing, you know you've hit rock bottom. But it's here, in this moment of just feeling alone, abandoned, hungry, and lost, that he remembers what life was like at home. He remembers that he has a father that loves him. And here in verse 17, we're actually in Luke chapter 15, verse 17, it says, "Then he began to think clearly again." When we go through difficult times, maybe you've run from God. You've decided that you were tired of just following the rules and you wanted to go out and do things your own way, only to feel lost and alone, realizing that you have a father that loves you. And some of us haven't had fathers here on earth that have loved us and cared for us. But we have a heavenly father that adores us, that made and created us, that knows our name. And so here in the story, the son says, "My father's hired servants have more than enough food, and here I am dying of hunger." "I know. I will get up and go back to my father, and I will say to him, 'Father, I've sinned against heaven and I've sinned against you. I'm no longer fit to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants.'" And so in verse 20, he got up and he went to his father. We have a heavenly father that loves us. And so no matter what we've done, there is no sin that is too big or too great for our Father in heaven to forgive us. We can go to him and we can say, "God, I love you and I am so sorry. Please forgive me." And we have the promise of God's word that we will be forgiven, for all have sinned, for all have fallen short of the glory of God. We can turn to the Father for our forgiveness, just like this younger son knew that he could go back to his dad and be forgiven too.